Hello all, I'm going to be doing the fan and feather on the knit machine with a little twist. You're not going to have the garter ridge in there like you normally would with a hand knit pattern. And I made up my own little chart here, which most of you would probably have. There was a problem with the bottom boxes here. I will fix that online. And I did put them in different colors, as you could see, so as you're going along, you know what box you're supposed to be going with. So, I do have 18 left to 18 right that I cast on. And as you see, I have already done up a few of these, because I wanted you to see what it looks like in the end. Now, you probably need to take your claw weights and move them up as you're working, because when you're transferring the stitches from the center here, sometimes they look like they want to pop off the stitches. So, having that little extra weight there will help. Okay, so in the first box, it tells you to take right 17 and move it to the right 18. So just find your right 17 needle. Take the stitch off, put it over to right 18. Then it tells you right 15 to right 16. I know I got to move that, so I'm pulling it out. And right 13 to right 14. Then right 2 to right 1. Right 4 to right 3. And right 6. To right 5. Now I forgot to move those out. Then you got left 2 to left 1, left 4 to left 3, and left 6 to left 5. Again, I forgot. I know I need to pull these out, and once you do these, you're going to be able to know which ones are going to be transferred over. Then you have left 17 to left 18, left 15 to left 16, and left 13 to left 14. So as you see, there's 2, 2, 2, 2. Now we're going to take those and move those out. So you take right 16 and put it over to right 17. And then right 14 to right 16. Right 3 to right 2. Right 5 to right 3. Left 3 to left 2. Left 5 to left 3. Left 16 to left 17, and left 14 to left 16. So now you have your three empty needles that we need to transfer these stitches over so that it is like an eyelet. And you get these eyelets, so it's every other stitch. So now we take right 12 and move this to right 15. Right 11 to right 13. Right 10 to right 11. Right 7 to right 5. And right 8 to right 7. And now for the left side, we take left 7 to left 5, left 8 to left 7, left 12 to left 15, left 11 to left 13, and left 10 to left 11. So now they're all spaced out. you have your every other needles there that are going to knit up. With the bonds, you're going to want to bring your empty needles out to hold in position. And you can open the latches now, it doesn't really matter. And this will make it knit a little bit easier for those machines. So now I'm going to knit 4 rows. And actually those went back on me. For the bond, you're going to, after the first row, you're going to take those stitches, those needles, and push them back into forward working position. And then knit the other 3 rows. And that's all there is to doing the fan and feather. Now, if you want to do the peacock flumes, or flumes, I guess it was, this chart here, the circles are eyelets. So this part here is this part here. And then this part here is the center, or the outside. This is a combination of 16 stitches. So you're going to do the same thing, except for you're going to have 2 stitches less. And I didn't really look, but I think the 2 stitches less are here on the fan. So just continue, you know, redoing the boxes again after you make all those transfers, knit up 4 rows. So if you're making this for a curtain or a valance or even a bed topper, you need to have a little loop in there for the rod to go through it. So what I would do is probably knit up, 20 rows, I guess, would be enough. Then you're going to take your weights off, and then you're going to fold this up, and then you're going to hang, and it probably would have been best if you had some kind of contrast and color in there. But if not, you know, it's not really going to make too much of a deal. But you just take and fold this up, and you hang 1 row back on these stitches. And that's going to give you that little fold there that you could slip the curtain rod through, or the bed, the cross member of the canopy bed over. And that's all there is to that. And here is your finished feather and fan. I did forget to mention that after you knit the 2 rows, you probably want to take your cast-on comb off. If you're working with a bond and have the black hem on there, it's going to be a little tough, but just be a little easy with it. Or you may want to do up some waist yarn. Push that, once you get that done up, push those behind the latches, do a closed cast on, and then start from there. That way you don't have the comb right at the bottom of the material. And as you see, it does make a little wavy edge on the bottom. So this would look nice on a sleeve or the bottom of a sweater. I do need to block this though, so that will stay out.